Hi friends, let us today understand how to solve a problem using impulse invariance method. So the problem for today is given as if HA of S is equal to 1 upon S plus 1 into S plus 2, we need to transform this to H of Z with a sampling frequency given as 5 samples per second. And they have told us to use impulse invariance method. So for impulse invariance method, let us start the solution. For impulse invariance method, I will get HA of S. From that, I will find H of T. From that, I will make sampling. So then I will do H of NTS. And then we will go to H of Z. But while solving problem, you will skip this step, and how that we will see. Now, in this four steps, I got this, I need to obtain this. To obtain this, we will apply Laplace, inverse Laplace transform. To obtain from year to year, I will do sampling with sampling frequency of given above. And then here I will apply Z transform. Correct. So let us first apply inverse Laplace transform on the given problem. If I wanted to apply inverse Laplace transform, I cannot use directly this transfer function. I need to do some adjustments. So for step one, apply inverse Laplace transform to obtain what? H of T. So then I will get, then I will use HA of S is equal to 1 upon S plus 1 into S plus 2, and let us apply partial fraction expansion on this. So if I apply partial fraction expansion, I will get A upon S plus 1 plus B upon S plus 2. Then we need to find the values of A and B. So A will be equal to, over here I can write as S plus 1 into HA of S at S is equal to minus 1. So we will get value for A as S plus 1. If I substitute over here, will get cancelled, and you will get 1 upon S plus 2 will remain, where S is minus 1. So it is minus 1 plus 2, which will give me the value as 1. So S A is equal to 1. Let us find B. For B value, let us take B equals to S plus 2 into HA of S at S equals to minus 2. So we will have B equals to S plus 2 will get cancelled, and I get 1 upon minus 2 plus 1, which will give me minus 1. So therefore, I will get now my new HA of S as 1 upon S plus 1 minus 1 upon S plus 2, because the value for B is minus 1. As we have received this, now I can apply inverse Laplace transform. And if I apply inverse Laplace transform, I'm going to get HA of T, which is nothing but inverse Laplace of 1 upon S plus 1 minus inverse Laplace of 1 upon S plus 2. So inverse Laplace of 1 upon S plus 1 is e raised to minus, okay, at, this is a, so that will give me minus t into u of t minus e raised to minus 2t into u of t, which is ha of t. Now I can just pull out u of t, and I can write e of minus t minus e of minus 2t into u of t, which is nothing but HA of t. So this is our HA of t. Now after finding this HA of t, I need to replace my t with NTS. So the next step that I will be doing is replace t with NTS. So now I'll get H of NTS equals to e raised to minus NTS minus e raised to minus 2ts, sorry, 2ts into n into u of nts, right? Then we will go to find, so this was step 2, that is sampling. So we did sampling. Now we will go for step 3, which is apply z transform. So when I apply z transform, I'm going to get h of z, which is nothing but summation n going from, let's say, minus infinity to plus infinity h of nts into z raised to minus n. Then we will get, this is my nts, but it is because u of nts is there, so limit will start from 0. So it goes summation n is equal to 0 to infinity h nts will give me e raised to minus nts minus e raised to minus 2 nts with u of nts in this period to be equal to 1. So I leave that. So this is my into z raised to minus n. Multiply individually, opening up the summation will give me summation, I don't write the limit now, e raised to minus nts into z raised to minus n minus summation e raised to minus 2 nts into z raised to minus n. Okay, so that I have split on minus. Then I can write this as summation n goes from 0 to infinity e raised to minus 1 ts into z raised to minus 1 the whole raised to n minus summation n goes from 0 to infinity e raised to minus 2 ts into z raised to minus 1 raised to n. This will give me 1 upon 1 minus e raised to minus ts z raised to minus 1, and this will give me 1 upon 1 minus e raised to minus 2 ts z raised to minus 1. Okay, this is your h of z. Now I will cross multiply and I'll get 1 minus e raised to minus 2 ts z raised to minus 1 minus with this minus it becomes 1 minus 1, and this minus and minus becomes plus e raised to minus ts into z raised to minus 1 divided by product of 2, 1 minus e raised to minus ts z raised to minus inverse into 1 minus e raised to minus 2s z raised to minus 1. Numerator will be this will go to, this will result into 0, minus 1 plus 1 will get cancelled. This will result into z inverse in common, and this will come as e raised to, let's say, minus ts minus e raised to minus 2 ts divided by 1 minus e raised to ts z raised to minus 1 into 1 minus e raised to minus 2 ts to z raised to minus 1. Let us put the value of ts. How to calculate ts? Now ts is equal to 1 upon fs, and they have provided the value of fs as 5 samples per second. So I will get 1 upon 5. So if it is 1 upon 5, then the value will be 0.2. So I need to put the value as 0.2 ts in this equation, and h of z will be equal to z raised to minus 1 into e raised to minus 0.2 minus e raised to minus 2 into 0.2, which is 0.4, divided by 1 minus e raised to minus 0.2 into z raised to minus 1 into 1 minus e raised to minus 0.4 into z raised to minus 1. So this is what the complete solution will be. And if you solve it further in terms of positive indexes of z, your final answer will be 0.148z divided by z square minus 1.48z plus 0.548. Just to give you a hint, what you have to do is you have to actually solve this in your calci, and then subtract their both values, then make product of this. There will be 4 different terms with z raised to minus 2 in the denominator. Take that minus 2 in the numerator, So this z raised to minus 1 and z raised to plus 2 will cancel and will give you z back, which is this z. This answer will be 0.418. Product answer will give you z square minus 1.48z plus 0.548. And that is the solution of the problem. Do not leave the problem at this stage. Please convert that problem till this stage. So I repeat the hint again. The hint is you have to find this, the value of this two function, the two values of e raised to minus 0.2 and value of minus e raised to minus 0.4 here and here also. Then multiply, then take z square in the numerator. One z will get cancelled. You will get one z over here and the denominator will adjust into the positive integers of z. That is how you have to find h of z. Thank you.